This weekend, over 20,000 revellers will invade the peaceful seaside resort, hidden gem actually, of Teignmouth in Devon. It's the biggest thing to happen there since 1967, when the Beatles stayed a night on the seafront. How about that? Claire Nazir is there to tell us more. Very good morning to you, Claire. I love Tinny. Dawlish Warren next door. It's lovely.
It's just beautiful. In fact, this whole area is very famous for its idyllic coastline, its pier, its promenade. And it's been taken over by, it's a huge stadium event, to be honest. It's like a festival down here. There's security, there's burger bars, and just behind me here, you can see the stage. And behind that is the Crazy Golf, which is the backstage area. So to be honest, they're really embracing this whole area. It's Muse. Now, Muse are an internationally known rock band. Three local guys from Teignmouth, and they're down here to launch their new album, Resistance, which is out on the 14th of September. And I caught up with two of them yesterday. That's Dominic the drummer and lead vocalist, Matt. Take a look at this.
I used to come in and play football and stuff when I was young on this, right where we are here. Exactly. And sort of sunbathe and go to the beach just over there. And to see a big stage put on it, it's quite bizarre. Yeah.
So you grew up here and you met at school?
When we were about 13 or something, and we played in a few bands together. Me and Matt were in a band. Me and Matt actually met for the first time, probably like here.
Just right there.
It really is a seaside town, population 10,000. So you're doubling the population of Teignmouth, basically.
Exactly, yeah.
Any old teachers or people who you can now say, hey, we've made it?
Oh, plenty of them, yeah. There's lots of old teachers coming. Actually, one teacher, Jill Bird, actually, was a great teacher who actually was quite into the band, actually. And she used to let us play sometimes, rehearse in the school after hours, you know. So hopefully she'll be coming down.
So is that Miss Bird?
Miss Bird is
hopefully coming down. And was the headmaster, did he say, you've got to get a real job, boys?
Yeah, it was plenty of, there's a lot of that. In fact, the mayor, believe it or not, the mayor actually put a CD, our first CD, there was a picture of him putting it in the bin because he thought the music was too loud and a little bit too rock for the area. So hopefully we're going to play that song. We just bumped into an old school friend.
He's the drummer in one of the bands that we used to be in.
He's now in the police force, yeah. Another one of our friends, the chief of police as well, which is quite funny. But yeah, I got a call from, my first girlfriend, when I was 12, 13. The first girl I ever kissed, Becky Powell, lovely girl. She came around to my house, had a little coffee and had a chat about the old days and gave me some tickets. It was lovely to see her.
It's lovely, isn't it? It's home from home.
Yeah.
You've almost come full circle, haven't you?
Yeah.
And you've got friends and family coming down as well.
They're all going to come down. Lots of cousins and family, lots of people are coming down. Loads of old friends have kind of been getting in touch, asking for tickets, kind of thing, but it's going to be great. So I imagine when we're on stage, we'll probably be able to like pick out a few faces that we literally haven't seen for like 10 or 15 years.
You were the first band to play the new Wembley Stadium, and this is so much more intimate, so much smaller.
Yeah, but this one's going to be a little bit more toned down. We're actually going to dress the stage up like an old sort of Victorian Punch and Judy type thing, you know? So it's going to have all these kind of weird curtains. And we've got in a lot of these kind of circus performers, like fire breathers and jugglers and people on penny farthings and stuff that are going to be sort of hanging around the town. So it's going to feel like a sort of retro Victorian seaside event, I think.
You've created this sort of allocation for the local people so they don't get annoyed with you.
We put most of the tickets down at Carlton Theatre, which is just around
there. So people had to come and get them all. So the locals were finding the queue kind of thing there.
Do you come back down to Teignmouth regularly? Because obviously your family live down here, don't they?
Yeah, I come down, Christmas time, that kind of thing, and sort of people's birthdays when I've got a bit of time off. I come see my mum.
You're heading off to the US after this and supporting U2.
No, looking forward to playing with them. They're a great live band, and I'm sure we're going to learn a lot by watching them because we're going to see them about, we're playing with them about 10 times across the east coast of America.
You hung out with them before?
I had to do a photo shoot with it was Elton John, Bono, and The Edge. Yeah, and I was sort of sat on the couch going, oh, I'm not quite sure what I'm doing here.
I mean, what do you talk about?
Actually, The Edge is really—he's actually quite a techie guy. So I was talking to him about equipment and musical equipment and stuff. And Bono was kind of reciting some poetry about success and how you should enjoy the ride or something.
Had no idea Muse were from Tinny. I think that's absolutely fantastic, Claire. They seem like good chaps. I said earlier on that they were free concerts that they're giving down there. It's not that. Actually, they've allocated quite a lot of tickets to the locals, haven't they?
They have, yes, but the locals are ready for the influx of 20,000 people. The local cafe just there are making little Muse biscuits. I think everyone's very excited. In fact, when I arrived at 4 o'clock this morning, there were fans queuing up, even though they had tickets. So everyone it's like a good festival atmosphere down here. I think it's going to be a dry night tonight and tomorrow night, but at the moment, the Den, which is normally a bowling green, now is going to accommodate 10,000 fans. It's a bit waterlogged, so they've got a lot to do today before the show at 6 o'clock. Their single is out on Monday, and actually me and Penny Smith and Lorraine Kelly were dancing to it yesterday in our dressing room because it's such a fabulous full sound. It's a wonderful single, and we're all very excited they're coming down.